My name's Erin Haynes, and I am an environmental health scientist. And I first did an undergraduate degree in biology, and then I minored in chemistry at Wilmington College. And then I went to the University of Cincinnati for environmental toxicology. And then I knew I wanted to know more about what chemicals do in the body, so I went to the University of Michigan School of Public Health for a degree. It's called a doctorate in public health and environmental health sciences. I'm a researcher. I do environmental health science research, and I'm a faculty member. So I teach courses, but I also do environmental health research. Fracking is unconventional natural gas drilling, and it is a very extensive process. So there is the drilling component where they do frack, meaning break up the ground, and they do fracture the rock, and then cause fissures to come out of the shale, which it releases the natural gas. It is an amazing technology that the engineers in the petroleum industry have developed, but the communities are having lots of questions about potential exposures. They're seeing effects on their community infrastructure and their roadways. It takes hundreds of trucks per well site to make the operation happen. Well, one of the first steps was to talk to the community members. We call them key informants. So I worked on a project in collaboration not only with my local team here, but also at the University of Rochester, and I partnered also with the University of North Carolina in Chapel Hill. And together we did a key informant interview. So we identified key people in the communities. There are three states: New York, North Carolina, and Ohio. And we identified people who may be affected the most or be interacting with issues related to fracking. So that would mean physicians, community members, people with in the water treatment facilities, people in chambers of commerce. And then we talked to them and asked them what are their perceptions of fracking, what issues they're finding, and then how do they get information? Because one of the other components, one of the other pieces of being a scientist is taking the information that we learn through research back and giving it back to the communities. So we wanted to know how best to do that. And then in another study, we're looking at actually measuring and quantifying the amount of chemicals that are in the air near well sites. I think a good success is that the community is wanting, they're anxious to know these answers. They live with it every day. It's either in their yard, in their neighbor's yard, this is in eastern Ohio, or they can smell things, they see the trucks, and they want to know these answers. Does it affect their health? And is it in their air or is it in their water? So that's what I hope to accomplish with this, and that's the goal, to do the research to answer the question, is it in their environment, and then does it get into their body? That would be a next step. The first step we'll do is the environment. Is it in their environment?